NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration, presents Aeronautics and Space Report. Looking down from their 250-mile-high vantage point this coming May, astronauts on board the Skylab space station will study our Earth as it has never been studied before. These high-flying prospectors will be searching for new mineral deposits and geologic features that might cause earthquakes. Inside their roomy space station, they'll be testing manufacturing techniques unique to weightless space. The effects of weightlessness on the human body for long periods of time will also be studied. To find out how well the Skylab command module can withstand cold, a series of cold weather tests were conducted at the Eglin Air Force Base Climatic Laboratory in Florida. The tests were done as a contingency precaution, since one of the Skylab crews will be launched this winter into a higher angle orbit than usual. What engineers wanted to do was find out how well the command module could withstand winter conditions in the North Atlantic in the unlikely event a landing was made there. The tests included three men inside the spacecraft for up to 24 hours. The 25-degree air temperature, coupled with a 33-degree water temperature, and 30-mile-per-hour wind from a wind and spray machine turned everything ice cold. Preliminary results indicate that the command module is a fit and sturdy vehicle in a cold environment and is capable of supporting three crewmen indefinitely. Skylab, this country's first space station, is nearly ready for its maiden voyage into Earth orbit. Shown here in animation is a new Applications Technology Satellite, ATSF. Managed by NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center, it is scheduled for launch next year. This unique satellite will be used to broadcast educational and informational programs directly into remote areas of the United States, such as the Rocky Mountain region and Alaska, and into small villages in India. One of the key parts of ATS is its 30-foot diameter antenna. The huge parabolic antenna opens to form a giant umbrella. When fully deployed in space, it can receive and relay back to Earth voice, video, and data signals. In the timberlands and flat semi-arid expanses of the Rockies, some 300 small, inexpensive aluminum dish antennas will pick up the signals and pass them along to the TV sets, radios, and computers that form the user end of the closed-circuit network. Involved in the project will be NASA, the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. It takes 40 men to fold the big antenna, making it ready for another test opening. That's what these men are doing at the Manned Spacecraft Center, Houston. Here's what the antenna looks like as it opens. ATSF, a new satellite capable of linking human resources with technological resources, and a chance to extend educational communications into presently inaccessible places. This has been an Aeronautics and Space Report presented by NASA, the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. When fully deployed in space, it can receive and relay back to Earth voice, video, and data signals. In the timberlands and flat semi-arid expanses of the Rockies, some 300 small, inexpensive aluminum dish antennas will pick up the signals and pass them along to the TV sets, radios, and computers that form the user end of the closed-circuit network. Involved in the project will be NASA, the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. It takes 40 men to fold the big antenna, making it ready for another test opening. That's what these men are doing at the Manned Spacecraft Center, Houston. When fully deployed in space, it can receive and relay back to Earth voice, video, and data signals. In the timberlands and flat semi-arid expanses of the Rockies, some 300 small, inexpensive aluminum dish antennas will pick up the signals and pass them along to the TV sets, radios, and computers that form the user end of the closed-circuit network. Involved in the project will be NASA, the Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, and the Corporation for Public Broadcasting. It takes 40 men to fold the big antenna, making it ready for another test opening. That's what these men are doing at the Manned Spacecraft Center, Houston.